Hello everyone, so I will cover the homebrew basics in this video. So let's start. So first of all, what is homebrew? So homebrew is a free and open source package manager for Unix like operating systems. Using homebrew, we can install the command line utilities as well as the graphical and UI based applications. So if we see on its official website also, it is written that it is a missing package manager for Mac and Linux systems. Although it is mostly used and mostly popular for the macOS systems. So if we go to this link, so we will see that it is written this is a missing package manager for macOS or Linux. We'll see shortly why it is called the missing package manager. Okay, what is package? So in this video and the coming videos of homebrew course, you will hear a lot of time about the packages. So what is package? So package is a collection of software files which gets installed together at the same time. Let's suppose we are installing any command line utility or any application. So that is a package. For example, we are installing Git. First of all, we will download the package of Git and then we will install that. So that package will contain all the software files which are required for proper functioning of the Git. So the combined files, software files, are called the package. Okay, let's now talk about why homebrew was required. What was the importance? So if we talk about all the Unix based operating systems like Ubuntu or RHEL, Fedora, all of these have some built-in package managers. For example, Ubuntu has APT or Red Hat Enterprise Linux, which is also called RHEL, so that has yum. But if we talk about macOS, so that is also Unix based system, but it does not have any built-in package manager and it just have the app store. But the app store has the limitation that it has only UI based applications. That was the problem statement which homebrew solved. So let's see how it solved that. So here homebrew became the lifesaver for us. So what does homebrew give us? So what are the things that homebrew bring to the table? So first of all, if we talk about when homebrew was not there, let's say we want to install some application. So first we will go to the official website of that application, or if that is a open source, so then we will go to the GitHub repository of that. Then there would be some certain steps to install that application, so we'll follow that and we will install that application. And each application and each utility will have different steps to install that. But in case of homebrew, we do not need to worry about the installation steps. We just need to follow just one command, which is brew install and that particular app name. So homebrew abstracts all the installation complexity behind it. So we just need to remember only one installation command, which is brew install app name, and similarly for uninstallation, we just write brew uninstall and that particular app name. The second thing homebrew gives us is it is an open source tool, and also it helps to install any open source utilities and applications. So we do not require to solely depend on the app store now. So that is the another thing that homebrew brings to the table. That's all for this particular video, but in the coming videos we'll discuss all the homebrew terminologies like tap, cellar, formula, cask. All these things we'll discuss in detail. Then we'll do some practicals around the installation of different homebrew packages. Then we will explore all the commands which homebrew supports. So we will go and see each and every command in detail. Then we'll see the different behavior of homebrew for Intel or the silicon based Mac system. So Homebrew behaves differently for silicon based Mac systems and the Intel based Mac systems. So we'll see that also. That's all for now. Thank you. See you in the next video.